I'm back in camp this morning after having a crack at what looked like quite an exceptional whitetail buck I saw yesterday morning. He was way up under the bluffs here in some pretty gnarly alpine scrub. I couldn't get onto him. I walked through all the country I saw him in yesterday, but I couldn't find him. He must have moved on. Anyway, in my last video I talked about exposure modes, during that video I learned a big lesson about bloody microphones and wind. You couldn't quite hear a lot of what I was saying, so I just want to recap on what I was trying to get across. What I was saying was, when you've got the time, it's best to use manual mode, selecting all three exposure settings yourself. That way you've got the exposure bang on and you'll get a really good image. In that case with the Mobitar, while I was still well back from them, I was able to take that reading, and provided the light didn't change between then and when I stalked in on them, that setting I'd put into the camera was going to be bang on. The beauty of that situation though was I had lots of time to do that. Quite often, especially with wildlife, you know, you don't have the luxury of that time. And that's when you can use your aperture priority mode, or shutter speed priority. Aperture priority is when you set the exposure yourself. With wildlife photography, inherently we're working in low light conditions, whether it be under the bush canopy or, you know, early morning, late evening when the animals are most active. So what you're aiming for by fishing that exposure, and generally you'll fix it at wide open or not far from it, is getting as much light onto that sensor as possible. One disadvantage of the manual exposure is, like I say, not having the time. Quite often, you know, you'll be stalking along and you just don't know when you're going to see an animal. And often it's a case of having to just up, shoot, and hope like heck you get a good image. By using the aperture priority, you're relying on the camera to set the, not the exposure, the shutter speed to hopefully get a good exposure. Now, cameras are pretty smart nowadays, but they can also be pretty dumb. If it doesn't read the scene right, you'll get an image that's either overexposed or underexposed. Yesterday was a classic example. I was stalking through some steep, scrubby, rocky country, and just the nature of the terrain meant that anything I did see was going to be sudden and probably with very little time. So I was in that aperture priority mode. I had it set at f7.1, which is a couple of notches off wide open, and I had a white-tailed doe and fawn walk right up to me. Or when I say right up to me, it was about 20 metres away. Close enough that I had to pull the zoom right back to 100 mils just to fit them in the frame. And in that situation, it was bright sunlight. I had the aperture fixed and the camera simply got it wrong. And the images came out overexposed. I'll just show you on the back of the LCD screen here. I'm not sure if you'll be able to see or not, but yeah, there's one there. I don't know how well you can see that, but that's an overexposed image, so hopefully it's not too far gone and I'll be able to pull the highlights back in post-processing and hopefully come out with a good image. So yeah, aperture priority is ideal when you know you haven't got much time. Also in those low light conditions. Now, shutter speed priority is similar, except you physically set the shutter speed and the camera will take care of the aperture. Shutter speed priority is really good for any subjects or scene that involve movement, birds in flight, running animals. You can fix that shutter speed nice and high to freeze that action, and the camera will hopefully set the aperture to get a good exposure. Yeah, so that'll be photography tip number two. Just gonna have a kip now in the middle of the day. The animals will be bedded down in the shade. I proved that yesterday, that I busted two or three white-tailed does that were bedded under scrub in the shade. But I want to have a look at that scrubby sort of face fan over there. I saw quite a few, well, I saw four white-tail on it yesterday, so I'll sneak up there this afternoon and see if I can't get in on them. Cheers, fantastic country up here. Boy, gee, it is. Beautiful. Cha!
And a wee soothing love song that I can recall. laying everybody low with a love song that he made.
Well, I just got back from stalking that face further up the valley that I said I was going to have a look at tonight. Saw four on my side. Got busted by all of them. Had the big white flag showing to me. But I was glassing back across on the face I was on yesterday and saw another eight over there. Including a group of five, which was great to see. Earlier on when I was talking about the exposure modes, I completely forgot to mention ISO. Not used to talking to the camera, so my brain probably got a bit rattled. So yeah, ISO is the third of those big three exposure settings. ISO refers to the sensitivity of the sensor, and one downside of high ISO setting is resulting noise in an image. So yeah, when I'm either in aperture, one of the priority modes, or manual, I always start off with as low ISO as possible, and as it gets darker or light conditions worsen, I got the luxury of upping that ISO until to the point where, to my mind, the noise is not acceptable. Different people accept different levels of noise in their image, and on top of that, you got different cameras cope with noise better than others. So somewhere along the line, you'll have a level that's acceptable to you. With my camera set up, I don't like to go beyond 1600. Anything beyond that, it's more just a record shot than anything. The noise is just too great, to my eye anyway. And another thing I should mention, no matter what mode you're using, a key to getting good images quickly is being familiar with your gear. A lot of cameras, you can customize the buttons to certain settings, so what you should be aiming for at the end of the day is getting familiar with your gear to the point where you can adjust any of those three exposure settings, ISO, aperture, or shutter speed, without taking your camera away from your face. Like I say, you can customize those settings to buttons on your camera, so all three can be adjusted with just your thumb or your forefinger, which means you can keep that camera up to your eye, make your adjustments, anything that's necessary, and that saves a heck of a lot of time. But again, it's just becoming very familiar with your gear. That's the key. Oh yeah, just about to cook tea. Butter chicken and potato. Last meal for the night, heading out tomorrow, so been a good trip. First time hunting whitetail. I've yet to been to Stewart Island, so yeah, first crack at whitetail, and gee, they're challenging all right. The number of times I've had that white flag shown to me. Yeah, oh, they're cool little deer. Cheer up.
Of serenade, laying everybody low with a love song that he made. And he finds a convenient street light, stares right at the shade, say something like you and me, babe.